being probably the you know, the guys who are going to eventually compete with NIP. I do hope that happens, because like I said yesterday, I mean, that's somewhat of a dream matchup for the 1-6 fanboys. Obviously, NIP, not the team that they were in 1-6. They do have a bit of a mix going on with you know, some new additions, but I think they play to the same standard that you would have seen from NIP in 1-6.
Yeah.
If I know it's kind of... You can't compare them because they're two different games, but I think the standard of play in goal is comparable to the standard of play in 1-6.
Yeah. Oh, I mean, sorry, it opens up with two nice...
Here we go. Oh, Zeus, double headshots as well. Pistol round underway here. I'm going to see MBK as last man standing, trying to spam away with that Glock. This is just a case of him basically trying to prolong this as long as possible. Yep, and there's the first round on the board for Na'Vi. So pistol rounds underway. And how important is that on the CT side to get that early advantage, considering the Glocks are somewhat OP?
Yeah, it's always great to pick up the pistol round at CT, considering this overpowered Glock at the moment. And also, they kind of just locked it down. It was no problems. It was never a question about Vera Games maybe clutching that round either. I think they can feel quite comfortable having won that first round of the quarterfinal that easily. It's always going to settle some nerves. And let's see. Just having a quick look at the overview here. It does look like Vera Games are heading over towards the A bombs up for this eco. And I'm interested to see if they're doing this new meta game, really, where they just go all in, smoke design, get
rush plants. Yeah. Yep. God, four style, basically. I mean, the extra cash does make a difference. And really, I mean, there's two sort of... I suppose there's two ways of thinking about it. I mean, if you do rush plant, you're pretty much giving up the round, but you're going to get the money.
Yeah.
If you do, you know, try and pick off and grab a couple of weapons, then that's just as equally viable, I suppose. But I would say at this point now, at this level of play, with the coordination, smokes, flashbangs, and HE, much easier to get the rush plant. As you can see, the plant has gone down. It's going to be defused here. It was... Basically, they did push Na'Vi quite far, though. I mean, Starge was last man standing. That's kind of surprising, to be honest.
Really well done by Vera Games. That was... it looked like kind of what we were talking about, a rush for the plant. They did just jump onto that bomb site, put down the smoke, so the bomber could get that bomb planted without any troubles. But at the same time, they've got that sick individual aim, and considering how good the pistols are in the global offensive, they were close to taking that round, Jay.
Yeah, I mean, that would have been a complete turnout for the books, and I think it would have really screwed Na'Vi over. But Starix coming up with the goods, as you can see, 5-0 right now, so definitely the MVP in server so far. And we are seeing HE exchange. That didn't do any damage to Very Games. Existence did get dropped to 11 HP, though. Not before C9 took 39 damage himself, though, but it's not going to stop him from grabbing the headshot onto Smiths. As you can see, forced buy here from Very Games. You've got AKs and Galils. I think they should have probably played this a little bit smarter and gone for the full buy and you know, had one AWP on maybe Kenny or Smiths, because I mean Mirage is a kind of tight map, but there are plenty of opportunities to actually get angles for picks, so I think they are probably going to be kicking themselves about that, because as you can see, it was basically a 5-0 whitewash there on the first buy round. So 3-0 now the scoreline. We should very well see another eco here from Very Games.
Yeah, I've got 2 points to make about that round. First of all, I totally agree with not they shouldn't have done that hasty buy. They should go for that AWP, because in an afterplant situation on A, having that AWPer in that pit where they enter the bomb site is it's going to be huge for them. It's going to be so much easier to hold that site. So I don't understand why Vera Games had to force that early buy. And also, I noticed Sini being quite offensive for the CT play. He pushed all the way into that pit, and is that something Na'Vi's used to doing, like playing that offensive?
I mean, I couldn't say that I've seen them play Mirage too much, to be honest. So I'm not certain if that is something that is part of the sort of repertoire in the playbook, but it definitely was the right thing at the right time. It did seem to discombobulate Very Games. They couldn't get any kind of like bearing on what he was supposed to be going after C9, picked up Kill and Smiths. And really, that just led to them being picked off one by one on the flanks. Now it's 4-0. Round was obviously a full-blown conclusion.
Yeah.
Na'Vi not going to be dropping any pistol rounds, I don't think, here on an eco anyway. As you can see, top scorer in serve. It's going to be Starix technically, because he does have a 5-0 scoreline. At least if you're working out from KDR like Go does now. But I would say Zeus on that 6-1 scoreline right now with 3 assists has been probably the standout player in the first 4 rounds here.
Yeah, I agree. And we see a buy coming out of Vera Games now with an AWP on Kenny S. So we will see that AWP being utilized. And once again, we see Senia all the way down offensive here. Looks like Na'Vi really enjoys playing this offensively, but NBK knew that this was coming from the previous round. So got that pick, and it's now down to a 5v4, Jay.
Yep, 5v4, but MBK did take a serious amount of damage there from C9, so one good M4 shot here would drop him. Seems like we are going to see Smith open up with the AK-47, drops Edward. Zeus with the M4 return to Scream, though, so now he's not going without a fight here. 4-on-3 now. It doesn't look like we are seeing MBK start to broach over towards the A site. The bomb is just outside of A, so it does look like we are going to see the bomb go A here. Still got some 47 seconds on the clock, so enough time to sell a fake, but Zeus is going to stop that. Smith's returns, though, so still the one-man advantage here for Very Games. But looking at the health, I mean, you can see that if Starix or Markloff get into a firefight, well, I'm saying that Markloff's got his AWP, so I suppose if he doesn't miss, he's going to kill just about anybody. But with the health as it is, I'm probably going to take Na'Vi here for the victory in this round.
Oh, Markloff will get that opening kill onto Smith, and the bomb is dropped, but his teammate A6ans gets that bomb picked up, and Markloff a bit hastier, pushing straight in behind. Don't want them to get that bomb plant, I think, Jay.
Yeah, well, I don't think Markloff's going to be able to stop it here as the bomb's going down in the hands of Existence, but as you can see, only got, what, 56 health between the two players? That's not particularly great.
What's good for them is Markloff will utilize that AWP, which pretty much takes 100 HP anyway, so it doesn't make that much of a difference, but we've got Starix and he's a class aimer. Oh, Markloff changes
to switched out, yeah, I was just about to create that because obviously he knows that they're low in health. Obviously, I did check this as well yesterday. You do get damage from the console, so they'll have worked out the damage that we've done. Obviously, at that point, the smart thing to do is to switch out the AWP for the M4. Now, I'd imagine he's...
Wow.
Has he got it? Yeah, he's got this.
Yeah, he's got it, but Starix pretty much just ran over that bomb and didn't like see it on his monitor, so he got well confused on that bomb site, Jay, not finding that bomb.
Oh, Starix, no! He tried to toss off his M4 to pick up the AWP, and it looks like he lost the M4, didn't grab the AWP.
Always a fun thing to happen.
Yeah, but then again, the 5-0 up, so I can guarantee you they're not stressing about losing one weapon like that. I mean, it's... $3,100 at the end of the day, it's not irreplaceable.
And we got once again a buy round here for Very Games, and that means Kenyas has to utilize that AK. Smith opening up onto Zeus, and the bomb is now ticking down. In a couple of seconds, there we go. Oh no, Edward stops the bomb plant, Jay.
Yep, and C9 coming in from behind as well, picks up the frag as well, so it's not looking good here for Very Games. MBK taking a lot of fire from him. It looks like he's trying to make his way into the A site. Now he's forced back to look mid on the flank here as we got the B rotation coming in. As you can see, Edward going to grab that kill into MBK. So good communication here from Na'Vi, pointing out exactly where MBK was. One of the key kills to pick up on that Very Game squad, to be honest. I mean, MBK, Kenny, and Existence, for my money, have probably been the standout players so far. Not that Scream hasn't held his own, but really, I mean, what we saw in Inferno yesterday was nothing short of spectacular. Now, Edward with the headshot. Nicely done. That's going to drop Kenny. So just Scream left alive here. Let's get away from auto director because it never drops onto the last player. As you can see, flashed out onto site. Now he's going to get his vision back here. He knows exactly where.
Scream.
He knows where Edward is.
Starix picks up that kill, but nice little headshot by Edward, and then reply from Scream. So there's not missing skills here from any of these players, but. Na'Vi up 6-0. And
crazy scoreline for this point of the game. I would have figured that Very Games, if anything, would have been, you know, I would say 4-2 up by now on the sort of prediction front. But I mean, it doesn't seem like they're capable of actually getting in on this A site here. I mean, B's not really a preferable site, but at what point do they start to think, okay, well, we're hitting a brick wall here at A. Do we switch it up and go B? Because it's been 6 rounds of A play with only 2 plants.
Yeah, I totally agree. They could try the threat tactic, which is splitting B, which never works, according to threat.
Well, it did work yesterday. He did have to eat crow, actually, so yeah.
Well, the exception that proves the rule, isn't it? Well, we're down to, once again, Very Games being 2 players down, and now they're actually 2 versus 5, and Scream gets that good kill onto Xenio. And trying to look for that other CT that holds this A-bomb site. Oh, smart decision by Scream. Checking behind, get that kill onto Zeus. And they managed to get this down to 2v3. It's a lot more possible for them now, Jay.
Yeah, most definitely. I mean, the fact that, obviously, Markloff is going to have the AWP. If he misses one shot, it could make that a 2 versus 2. But Markloff isn't really inclined to miss his AWP shots. Now, as you can see, Smith's out aiming him, though. AK to the dome. It does seem like we're going to see the plant here. Yep, Smith's going to put this bomb down on the A site. Going for the old safe plant, not really a great spot to cover, but obviously with Starix and Edward still in play, well worth taking the extra time to get behind the box and actually plant in a safe spot. So you see a 2-on-1. It looks like Scream, obviously knowing Starks' angle coming in. They both know where exactly each other is here. We've got smoke going out, so that's going to give Edward a little bit of a distraction here. He knows that probably Scream was going to move to his left. Didn't actually help him in the end, though.
This was, you do realize this was a 2v4 or a 2v5 from Rare Games. Insane play by Rare Games coming out and showing that they are more than capable of bringing Na'Vi to their knees if they just play up to par. Fantastic play by Rare Games.
I think a lot of that boils down to that, you know, Smith's headshot on Markloff.
Yeah, it does. That's such an important kill, Jay.
Yeah. I mean, anytime you open up that A site and you take away the, you know, the vision from Markloff, because the thing is, even if Markloff misses a shot, he's going to call what he's missed.
Yeah.
That's going to allow Edward to come in when he comes in from the rotation to actually pick him off. So anytime you can drop him and then you know, get out of his line of sight, find yourself a new spot quickly on the A site and bait Edward in on the rotation, you should get two kills out of it, not just the one.
Yeah.
So, I mean, that's going to have to be the crux of the very game strat here, is to control Markloff. Now, we do have an aggressive
Edward.
Push. Yep, Edward, that was aggressive. If it would have worked, we would have been singing his praises, but it did not work. And as you can see, I mean, really only removing 80 HP from existence, and now that does open up the approach to the A site. So
keep in mind now that Markloff only has the M4. That means that Na'Vi's actually... They don't have the amount of money you would think they have. So Rare Games have, even though they're down 1-6, they've done a good job picking up kills every single round, making the economy of the CTs not that good.
Oh, this is cheeky. Existence playing a patient game. He knew he had 20 HP, so I think Rare Games pretty much decided to leave him there, and you know, he was singing Kumbaya, just waiting for a lucky kill, which he did get. Now, as you can see, MBK, and that's going to be Scream. They're going to be moving through the carpeted apartments. Bomb going down here, so we are going to see the plant from Kenny. 3-on-2 situation. Markloff down to 47 HP, C9 all the way up at 100. Seems like we are just going to see a save here. Do you think that's the smart thing to do when you 6-1 up?
It is. I think that if Markloff had an AWP in hand, they would kind of just try to get an opening kill with that AWP before deciding to save or not. But having Markloff on that AK, it's just it's not going to work to go in a 2v3 there after plant. It's too much of an advantage for Rare Games. So wise decision altogether to fall back and save those weapons, because we were already talking about the poor economy of the Na'Vi team.
Yeah, like you say, I mean, one thing that Rare Games have done well, even though they have taken, you know, basically a fairly heavy drubbing so far. I mean, the scoreline is 6-2, as you can see here on the scoreboard. They've been exceptional. I mean, Scream and Smith, really, are the two standout players who are at 7-7. So the fact that they have, you know, 1-1 KDRs means that they've been inflicting cash damage on the likes of Markloff, who right now is 6-4, so a little bit off his normal pace. But then again, he is playing Very Games, and I'm certain that they're anti-strathing against him. As you can see, we're already seeing the push into where Markloff would have been prior. You can see that from the overview here. It does seem like we are seeing a sort of mid-push towards A, which is the first time we've really seen an aggressive mid-push towards A. Let's try and drop you onto Smith here. As you can see him on the catwalk, spraying down with the AK-47. We do have a potential flank coming in here from Na'Vi. Drop you back onto the auto-director, because as that flank gets closer, the auto-director should throw us over to that, so...
Yeah, Senior was pretty offensive in that pit aspirin.
Oh, wow,
Edward.
Can Edward capitalize? Oh, my God, Edward should have been dropped twice over there. I'm not quite sure what Existence was playing at. I think the kind of jumping up and down in the ladder did throw him off a little bit. Oh, MBK and Kenny moving in, though. That's going to bring it back to just a one-man advantage here for Na'Vi. Now, Starks is going to make that a 3-on-1. Good pistol play. MBK still alive. He's going to drop C9. He's going to know where Starks is, but he's not going to have any idea where Edward is. So still a massive advantage here to Na'Vi, considering that MBK doesn't... Well, he has an idea where Starks is, but Starks will have moved by this point, obviously.
And he does not have the bomb in hand either, so... All pressure's down on NBK right now. He needs to pick up that bomb.
21 seconds on the clock as well, you'd have to say.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
I was going to say maybe the smart thing to do, though, would have been to save that AK. But then again, an AK is only 2,500. But you've got body armor, and I think he had nades on him as well. So I personally, in that position, would have played that a bit, you know, bit smarter, I think.
Yeah, for all we know, he was actually going to save that weapon in T-spawn there.
Yeah, it could have been a possibility. Yeah. I think what I would have done, though, is because it was a 2-on-1 and they had a decent idea where he was, I just would have dug in and made them come find me and just, you know...
Camp it up in C-spawn.
Camp it up, yeah. I wouldn't have minded having the weapon taken from me.
No.
I mean, eventually it was taken from him, but they would have to come find me to take it, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
But then again, what do I know? Anyway, Starix with the opening kill. That's going to be the headshot onto Smiths. Really, this doesn't bode well here for Very Games, does it? They're on Nico, they've already lost two frags, and they've not made any positional gain, as you can see.
Now, they will need at least five rounds here to feel comfortable going onto that CT side. I think they feel very confident going onto playing the CT side of this map. But obviously, having only two rounds, I don't think they have it in them. They need at least five rounds today.
I mean, the interesting thing here is that obviously Very Games did win the knife round and elected to stay T's, so I'm not quite sure what they're playing out there. Maybe they just want to know what they've got to do on the CT side.
Yeah, I think so.
And I know there's sort of two schools of thought when it comes to that. You can either just take your weaker side first. If it's a relatively close map, you can take the weaker side first, and then you know how hard and smart you've got to play second half.
Yeah.
Or you can go out and try and put up big numbers straight away and demoralize your opponent. So that's obviously what Na'Vi have the game plan to do. They are trying to get the better of Very Games here in the first half of the first map. Really, I mean, if Very Games, I'd imagine that they consider themselves favorites on Mirage here. If they lose Mirage, do you think that's going to lead to a drop in morale coming into Dust 2?
No, I don't think so. They're used to losing maps in big tournaments where they eventually end up winning over. Exists gets two kills with that eco gun.
Beast mode engaged. It's not going to stop Markloff from getting a nice, easy AWP kill there, but still impressive play from Very Games to grab those two kills, I suppose. But again, I mean, it's more cash damage being done to this Na'Vi outfit, but at this point now, they are going to have a decent bank balance, I think. Let's have a look. Who's got the least deaths? Because that's going to be who's going to be tossing weapons for Markloff. It's going to be more than likely, if anyone's going to throw him a weapon, it's going to be probably C9. So it's not like they're going to be short of AWPs here. So from this point forward now, I think it's going to have to be like three rounds in a row to force an eco from Very Games. CT side is obviously easy to force an eco onto because the M4 does cost more than the AK.
Yeah.
But even so, I mean, I still think it's going to have to be like three straight rounds here to get the Na'Vi guys on eco. So anyway, Existence making his move forward. Good flashbangs out. That's going to at least, even if there's nobody there, it's always good to get that flashbang onto the A site close coming out of the ramp like that, just because it means you don't have to worry about the right-hand side.
Yeah, and it's going to force the anti-flash also from the CTs, making them spend their flashes. But once again, Na'Vi just tearing through Very Games as they were a scrub team, really. I'm just really surprised to see this scoreline. I think Very Games has a lot more potential in them.
I do agree with that, but I think Na'Vi are coming on leaps and bounds. I mean, it was only going to be a matter of time before they found something close to the 1.6 form they had. I would say, looking at this, they're not far from being that team once again. I think, to be honest, if Na'Vi and Very Games played the same game, like if they both played CSS, the time that both teams were at the top of the game, I think Na'Vi would have been the better team, to be honest. So, all things being equal, I think Na'Vi have a distinct advantage. Now, saying that, Scream's not agreeing with me. He does manage to grab himself a pistol headshot. C9 with the M4 shutdown, though, it's going to be the bomb down as well. So, Very Games, even though they've got a slight advantage on health here with that bomb being down, it's now back up in the hands of MBK. I would say they're a disadvantage coming onto the A site here as MBK picks up another pistol headshot. Existence with his second set of doubles here. He's an absolute beast with the Glocks, but still with it all to do. Starix has got the range, he's got the health advantage, he knows exactly what Existence is going to be trying to do, and he is going to shut him down. He knew the path that he was going to take to try and get to the bomb, and he was having none of that. So 10-2 now the scoreline, and really, at this point, Very Games have got to be starting to get a little bit concerned, haven't they?
Yeah, they have to be concerned. It's 2-10 now. They need to kind of pick up the three remaining rounds. But I have to point out that there's been a lot of rounds which has boiled down to 1v1, 1v2.
Yeah, it's not like it's been complete crushed.
No, the scoreline does lie a little bit, yeah. Oh, we got an offensive push by Zeus up middle here. Will he be able to capitalize on it? Oh, he picks up one. No, Edward does. Gets picked off, though.
But if you look at the damage that was done to Smiths as well, and we see Scream getting dropped, that was definitely a good push here from Na'Vi. Zeus is going to grab double kills with the M4, eventually shut down by Existence. Now, Existence has been the one shining light so far for Very Games, but as we said, I mean, it's a team game. You can't expect one person at this level of play to carry a whole team. So, really, Existence has got to look towards Kenny here to do some damage with his AWP. Now, he does manage to get a shot off. I don't think he actually connected with that.
Yeah, he did. He put Starix down to 20 HP there. So it was a leg shot, and always going to be good forcing Starix to fall back. CEO He's been fantastic. He's been pushing offensively every single round on different places, and he's always picked up one or two kills. So nearly gets a team kill there also onto Star.
Will we have counted that as his third kill of the round? Or
yeah, it's just his insane reflexes. I'm really impressed about this senior guy. He's playing it out fantastically. It's not even top frag. Bottom number two, really.
Yeah, but I mean, the role he's been fulfilling, he's been kind of like the bruiser. He's been the guy going out looking for trouble early, establishing where very games are, and that's allowing Navi to actually adjust the bombsite defenses and get the flashbangs out at the right time. So even though he's not close to being a top scoring server, for my money, he's been probably Navi's most valuable player. I mean, he does have a positive KDR, so you know you can't say that he's pushing has cost Navi anything. Now, we have seen a flank coming here from Smith. He managed to catch them on the sly. Just managed to get two kills as well as screen picking up an AK-47 kill. This is a promising round here with Edward down. That's going to be the final kill coming in, so much needed round on the board though for Very Games. 11-3 now the scoreline, and if they can make this 11-4, I suppose it's the best of bad situation, but really the game will be Navi's to lose at that point, wouldn't it?
It will. Even with four rounds, they will be far from happy with their performance. I think that if they move on over to the CT side with four rounds from the T side, they will have to win that pistol round and just demolish Navi. And with the plays I'm seeing coming out from Navi, it's hard for me to see a Navi team struggling too much on that T side, Jay.
Yeah. I mean, especially considering they have to pick up pistols, that sets them, you know, pretty much up for the win. So. Really, it's all down to Very Games' CT side on the pistols, I think. We have seen Very Games start to move in towards the B site. First time we've really seen them put any pressure on B, so just seem like they are going to get a plant out of this. Obviously, a 3-on-3 situation, the health in favour of the guys from Na'Vi, but weaponry is in favour of Very Games here. Now, Existence and Kenny going to pick up two kills. That's going to leave Markloff as last man standing. Just have that AWP. So he's looking
What a shot!
Now, that was impressive. Switched out for the FAMAS, smart play, he's going to move forward, opens up with the 5.56 rounds through the box! Does he have time for the defuse though?
Yes.
Yeah, he's got plenty of time. He's going to grab that and that's going to make it a 12-3 scoreline. And that really is just about the best half that Na'Vi could have asked for Mirage.
Yeah, for Na'Vi to go onto the offensive side of Mirage with 12 rounds in the bag, they must feel over the hill.
Yeah, you know what's the craziest thing about that as well? That was probably the most uncharacteristic Na'Vi game that I've ever seen.
Yeah.
The fact that they were so aggressive, I mean, pushing out the bomb sites, you know, it sometimes even sending three and four guys out through mid and onto catwalk. Mm. It really didn't allow Very Games any sort of time to set up for an actual approach to a bomb site.
No, look at Senior. He's on the bottom of the Na'Vi team. But what he did, he was a bruiser. He always picked up the first kill of the round. He always pushed offensive to make Very Games strategies, having to change mid-round. I think Senior has been, it's weird to say when he's at the bottom, but he's pretty much been the guy who's made sure that Na'Vi can get these many rounds in the first
round. He's been the guy who's helped establish the defense, basically. I mean, he's the one who's calling sort of where everybody is. And then what you were seeing, if you watch the minimap, if you download the demo, you would see as soon as C9 actually gets out, figures out, you know, establishes some positions, you start seeing Na'Vi shuffle around the bombsite to cover the approaches.
Yeah.
So even though, I mean, he obviously finished with a positive KDR, so he was going, you know, more than 1 point.
Yeah, it's just
12 for 9, so I'll call it 1.15, I suppose his KDR would have been.
Yeah.
No, 1.2 actually, yeah, if we're going to be pedantic about it. So he was doing more damage than he was taking, obviously.
Yeah.
But he was also giving his team that advantage of being like, okay, you need to flash now. They're going to be coming in any second. As opposed to being like, I can hear somebody outside, but I don't know when they're coming.
Yeah,
obviously, when you do establish those positions, it makes the defense a hell of a lot easier.
Obviously, being at the bottom, it just means that the rest of his team were doing a fantastic job as well. But he just made the difference, just nullifying the strategies, taking out key persons in that Very Games lineup. But we are live with the pistol round of the second half. Jay, what do you think will happen? It will be a restart. There we go.
Yep. That's so we exciting. Are going to see pistols momentarily. I think what we're going to see is we're going to see much more of the same.
Yeah.
As much as I thought Very Games would have an advantage, it seems like Na'Vi have done more homework here on Mirage. I don't know if it's just the fact that they've had that A on lock, but really, it didn't seem like Very Games had any sort of answer to the you know, the C9 aggressive pushes followed up by the flashbangs and smoke to really obscure that sort of initial push onto the bomb site. So couple that with the fact that Markloff, you know, even in a 1v1 with the AWP, is almost unstoppable. I don't know what I can do here, to be honest, man.
Now they need to focus on this pistol round. They need to pick it up and scream. Jess picks up that kill onto Edward. Nice little shot there from him. Seuss replies onto Scream though to make it a 4v4. And they can't keep trading like this. This should be very games. They really need to make this an easy round for them, Jay.
Yep, they need to basically, I suppose, push the slight advantage that they have right now with Markloff and Starix being down to 62. They do have the better weaponry, rocking the Glocks, of course, so I do anticipate that we should see a plant at the very least here, but there's a very good chance that we would see a retake. As you can see, we've already got the rotation in from Starix and company, so bomb has gone down. Let's jump into auto director mode so we can see exactly what's going on here. As you can see, four members of Very Games sort of stacking towards the approach here on the rotation. So they've cut the rotation off. They're going to drop C9 on the push into the site. Looks like we are going to see Very Games hold out here with the pistols. Yep. I'd be very surprised if Starix on 10 health managed to clutch three kills here. Now he's managed to grab one of them. Is he going to get the second? He did a lot of damage.
Nah, they will get the defuse in time, I think. Smith will be dropped down, though. Oh, wow. That is way too close for Very Games. They cannot afford to lose a 1v4 against a 10 HP Starix.
Yep.
That's a bit scary.
As great as Starix is, that's just one of those, you know, really it needs one bullet. It needs one peek. You just need to go out spamming. You're going to hit him within three bullets. If you go out just clicking, you're going to eventually find one limb.
Because everyone is aiming for that headshot. So it's just...
But I would imagine that would have been called that damage had been done at the very least, and probably how much health was remaining.
Yeah,
so
it should have been.
Why would you not come out guns blazing? Uh-huh. You know, you've got the peak, you've got the angle, you're on that box.
Yeah.
Obviously, he had the drop.
He could have played off the footsteps as well. Scream didn't need to jump around on those boxes either. He could have just pretty much just peeked out when he heard the footsteps pushing onto the site. But, I mean, a bit too critical here. They wandered around. Now they just need to focus on not dropping any of these anti-eco rounds, really.
Oh, yeah, that would be tragic here if they did lose this against an eco. That would pretty much throw the game over to Na'Vi, to be honest, because the cash would reset. And then you would see sort of three straight gun runs from Na'Vi.
Oh.
Now we are seeing Edward with the opening headshot. We're going to see another plant here. So obviously going to be a full early buy because we've had two plants now. So.
And no, Starix picks up a kill as well. It's Very Games drop two players.
It might be more than a plant here. I mean, it could very well be an eco victory, which, to be honest, is massively uncharacteristic for Very Games. How many times have you seen in the past sort of 3 years Very Games get dominated like this?
The Very Games is not the team that drops eco rounds, and I still think they will win it, but they just made it way too close. Oh no, he's out of ammo. He picks up the kill on Edward. Will he get Starix? Yes,
nice.
He will. Well done by Scream, but will they get the defuse though?
Yeah, oh, Kenny's on it.
That is as close as you can get it though, Jay, isn't it?
It wasn't far from being sort of like, you know, butthole twitching moment there for Kenny. So really at this point now, 12-5 scoreline. Very Games in control, but the two rounds that we've seen had two bomb plants from Na'Vi, so obviously we're going to see... Are we going to see Markloff on the AWP? No, he's gone for the AK, so I guess you consider that a light buy, but everybody's all naded up, so for all intents and purposes, a full buy, just Markloff doesn't get the weapon he wants.
It's pretty much the same as we saw Very Games doing on the T side as well. Let's see if it affects Na'Vi the same way it did Very Games.
To be honest, I think Markloff is one of those guys who's, you know, multifaceted. Whilst he isn't necessarily the AWPer that say Kenny would be if given the chance to AWP, his all-around play is much better. So I think he's quite comfortable with an AK-47, to be perfectly honest. We've seen him rock that for mass as well. He's pretty damn good with that. Now, Kenny is going to drop Edward here, so it's the first opening pick. Starix also down to 13 HP, so we are looking like we are seeing a 4-on-4 here, but with a distinct advantage in favour of Very Games. As you can see, Zeus now dropped to 4 HP existence, and I guess it's going to be Kenny on the rotation here. MBK opened up with the FAMAS, switches out for the AK. Nice little pickup though. And we're now pushing into A site. Now, as you can see, we've got Na'Vi members on that A site. Only C9 left alive now as MBK grabs the headshot of the Markloff.
C9's been an insane player thus far, but will he do this 1v4? It's a couple of lower HP players. He picks up NBK, but does he have it in him, Jay? Will he be able to clutch this? He does have the bomb. He's got 20 seconds remaining and 100 HP.
I think he's probably going to fall back here. No, saying that, no, he's going to force the issue. Is he actually going to go for the plant? He's going to go for the plant. That's a gutsy move.
It's a good position to plant in as well, Jay. He will be able to do that safe. The next kill will pretty much decide it all. If he does get another kill, no, he won't, Kenny S. absolute beast with that AWP, and they do manage to pick up this round as well. So Vera Games on their way back here, Jay.
Yeah, patient play as well from Kenny there, waiting for that AWP shot. Rather than just, you know, willy-nilly pushing in. He could have switched out for mass. There was one just behind him, but deciding that he would wait for existence to come up behind him and push the flank, force him out, and then pick up the AWP shot. So good play from Very Games, even considering they did concede yet another bomb plant. I don't think they're going to be too stressed about conceding bomb plants as long as they keep winning gun rounds.
Yeah, if they keep winning the rounds and let them plant, they're fine, considering Markloff will never be able to put up with that AWP. And as long as they force Markloff off that AWP, they're going to have a lot easier time, I think. Even though he's able to pick up kills with the AK or Galil, he's not. I don't think he's half the player.
Yeah, it's not the massive psychological damage as well. I mean, yeah. The second you hear that, you kind of
piss your pants a little.
Yeah, you know shit's getting real at that point. So yeah. It's time to start, you know, digging in and start trying to just hold your angle and not peek. So it basically forces your opponent to cower when you have an AWP of that quality. So
yeah.
And it really, I mean, as we saw from the first half, one of the keys to victory for Navi was C9's aggressive pushes out of that A bomb site to establish positions. So if you do have an AWPer who can pick whoever does decide to make that peek, it makes the peek less viable. Now, as we see, bomb has gone down yet again here. 5-on-4 advantage in favor of Very Games, but you can almost count that bomb as sort of like a fifth member of the terrorist team if it's played correctly.
Yeah, it's pretty much equal. There's no advantages at this point, to be fair. Maybe the positional advantage for the Na'Vi team set up for that.
But Very Games have a grenades and smoke in reserve, so
exactly.
I say that negates the positional advantage. Not that you know that from watching it.
Wow, Kenny, yes.
Ninja defuse.
What a little ninja, this guy. Wow, that is such a well-done thing to do.
I think they actually...
Did they not hear the defuse?
I was going to say, I think they was just out of range to hear the defuse.
I think there was a lot too much of action going on with the
all the gunfire going on, yeah,
that
the distance
planned.
Away.
Probably planned.
I would imagine so. I mean, that smoke was pinpoint perfect. They did figure out where the bomb was before they threw the smoke, so... Then again, you would have expected Na'Vi, the second that bomb gets smoked up like that, you expect the team to be like, okay, they're going for a ninja here.
Yeah.
We need to start spraying down the bomb, because obviously at this level of play, I mean, you have set positions for those bomb plants, so you can have blind spray through smoke and boxes.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of surprised that Na'Vi didn't really open up onto the site. Then again, they had to engage with the rest of Very Games, so it's not like they could find an opportunity to engage, I suppose. So good play from Very Games. It's going to bring it back to 12-7 scoreline here. As you can see, Scream spraying away again. More kills through the smoke here. Seems looking for the pick onto the site. 4-3 in favor of Very Games. So Kenny now moving up with the AWP.
Oh,
he's going to be
wow.
looking for a frag, and he didn't actually connect, though. Kind of uncharacteristic. He's going to make the second shot, though. So not quite sure why Edward decided peeking against the AWP for the second time was a good idea, but uncharacteristic. We are seeing a fairly aggressive defensive side here from Very Games. Markov moving forward still. The AK-47, he's going to be flanked from both sides. Does manage to grab one kill.
2 HP though.
Yep, did manage to get a clip in, but it's not going to be enough. 2 HP against 2 members of Very Games. You know, 9 times out of 10, you're going to lose that firefight, even play the caliber of Markov's standard. Now, let's take a quick look at your scoreboard. For your money so far, Walkline, who's been the best player in server?
I'm still going to go for Scream. He's been constantly picking up those insane headshots with that AK or M4. Pretty much from impossible angles. I think he's the Senio of Very Games currently on the defensive side. Although another different approach, like playing a bit more defensively and going for that after plant situation. So once again, I would say I think you were spot on saying Starix would be the one of the most important players for Na'Vi here. He's on 18 kills here and 5 assists.
He has been probably the difference maker over towards the A site, which has meant basically they've had those plants, because it's Starix who's forced his way in time and time again. So the fact that Na'Vi have lost, you know, as many rounds as they have in the second half, but I think we've only seen them, what, eco twice?
Yeah.
Maybe 3 times, actually. Yeah, 3 times, thinking about it. But still, you would expect a lot more eco out of the amount of rounds we've seen picked up by Very Games. Just boils down to the fact that Starix and C9 are just basically barreling to the site and still getting the plants down, even though they're losing the rounds. So that's something that Very Games did not do. But like I said before, Very Games are not too bothered about that. They'll let Na'Vi by all day if they're winning the rounds. I mean, if they're capable of winning, you know, gun round after gun round after gun round, then fine, you force the plant, you run in, we'll figure out exactly where you are after plant and just decimate you and then defuse. Speaking of decimating, that's going to be existence with the FAMAS kill onto Markloff. So probably the key playmaker of Na'Vi down now. As you can see, Existence is positioned well onto Na'Vi, though, as he's flashed out. It's going to allow the A bomb site entry. Bomb has gone down. Smith and Kenny moving forward. Kenny with double AWP kill.
2v5 now, even though Vera Games are on pretty low HP, a couple of these plays, it's going to be hard for Zenyo to pick up any kills here. It's going to be picked off, it's all down to Edwards, down to 52 HP, and all he can do is run away and save that Weapon J. Nothing he can do in that situation. And I will have to pinpoint that my MVP picks are the ones with the most frags on the server. I'm pretty happy about that. Yeah, buddy.
does make your color analysis roll seem all the more pertinent, I suppose. Now, really, at this point now, it's I suppose a situation where it's anybody's game again. Yeah. Very Games had the momentum on the CT side. We've yet to see a victory in the half here, round victory from Na'Vi. So, at what point do Na'Vi start to stress out here? Because obviously, the whole time, Very Games haven't been taking a lot of cash damage from weapons. That's they've obviously been taking the bomb plants, but they've been getting the kills, and really, we haven't seen too many kills coming in the second half from Na'Vi. So, cash is going to start to be an issue here for Na'Vi soon. Whereas for the French guys from Very Games, obviously not.
Well, the interesting thing is, Very Games have won 6 rounds in a row now. That means that Na'Vi will always be able to buy now. The second day win a round, then it's time to get stressed. It sounds weird, but it's the then they can get the chance to lose a round again and have those two.
And then end up on double eco because it's 1500 respawn. So.
Exactly. Yeah. So that I would. It's a weird thing to say, but the second they win a round now, they should really be nervous about slipping up. Yeah.
I think the second they win a round, they're basically going to leave it till the very last second to push onto the site and look for Markloff to do as much damage with the AWP as possible. But then again, that requires Markloff having the bank balance to do so. Anyway, we're seeing 5 AKs. They're all starting to move over. You can see, I don't know what Autorite is playing at. Bomb has gone down on A yet again. A is obviously the site of choice here on Mirage. We've seen just the one B plant so far. So both teams do seem to be playing a heavy A stacks. 4 men on A and obviously the 5-man straight push in. You can see Very Games on the retake. Only Zeus and Edward left alive here for Na'Vi. What do you think the chances of a clutch here from Edward are?
He does manage to pick up that kill, but once again, Vergens really going all in on that. Just storm that site. I don't care how many players left. You just go and hit that defuse button. We'll take care of the rest. I think it's a great way of playing. It's just had so much success, Jay.
Okay, basically there's two ways of losing this T side on Mirage, basically. You have the quick plant, rush plant, get the money from that.
Yep.
Or you can do the way that Very Games did, where they were making it sort of, a one-on-one situation and then eventually losing out on the one-on-ones. Which way would you rather lose? I know nobody wants to lose, but I personally think that Very Games' approach to the T side was more successful than what we've seen from Na'Vi so far. Just for the fact that they managed to force some, economic woes onto the CTs of Na'Vi in the first half, where we've not really seen that yet from Na'Vi onto Very Games, have we?
No, Very Games have been the best team of this game thus far. I'm not saying that because they've won the last 7 rounds, but as T, they constantly picked up a lot of kills. Even though they lost most of the rounds, they kept the economy of that Na'Vi team all the way down at the bottom. And we're not seeing that from Na'Vi, really. Very Games always in a 4v1 situation when they defuse that bomb. So the bank accounts for the Very Games lineup is immense, man. They got their own bank account in Switzerland by now.
Pretty much offshore accounts here across the board for Very Games at this point. Now, again, another bomb plant here, but they've not removed anybody from Very Games, so it should be just a mere formality putting the retake on. Saying that, Markloff's going to grab the headshot into Existence. And that's really been one of the keys. I mean, Existence taking that sort of approach towards Catwalk. Now we're going to see Markloff again with another AK frag, so 2-for-1 that round. MBK does eventually drop him, but not before he took some fire. And you can see MBK eventually dropped by Starix anyway, so this could very well be the first round of the second half on the board here for Na'Vi. Seemed like they stopped Very Games from getting into a position to group up for the retake. So, first time we've actually seen them counter that retake, walk alone.
Yeah, and I like the balls of Very Games here, just falling back. I know that they could have gone for it and had money to buy also, but it's no point really risking it. But at the same time, it's starting to draw towards the end of the game. Na'Vi with the 13 rounds now. Only 2 rounds away from securing overtime on the first map, really. So, don't know, let's see if it pays off. It's that moment, Jay. It's that moment when they've won a round.
It's pretty much do or die now for Very Games. I mean, if Very Games can reset the cash here, they should have a distinct advantage in the second half. If they lose this next round, and then they lose the subsequent round after that, that's game point, obviously, and they would, I would say, be very close to an eco. At the very least, Kenny wouldn't be able to buy his AWP, so they'd be at a distinct disadvantage coming into what would be game point. So this could very well be the turning point of the game here. Do you agree?
I just have to point it out that Very Games is doing the same thing that they did back in Source. When that terrorist team got that round, they always do this offensive push to just shut them down immediately, put them back on their ass, really. Like, just bitch slap them and say, no, though. No more rounds for you. And it didn't work at all. Edward just picked up two easy kills in mid there, and it's a 3v5 now. But they do have Scream and Smith, who... doesn't even rarely. They always clutch rounds every game they play, so it's far from over for Very Games. As I said, that Scream gets taken out.
Yeah, commentator's curse comes in as Warclan singing his praises. Now it looks like we are going to see a tactical retreat here from Very Games. They're going to get out of there with the AKs and we have an M4. Yeah, an AK and an M4 and some grenades. So good retreat here. But really, that's it's not what Very Games were looking for this round. If they wanted to secure this second half, if they could have reset Navi's cash there, that would have almost secured them the game. What I will say is that MBK is still picking up kills here, so he's still doing damage. It's going to make it a 3-on-2. I don't think you're going to see Navi particularly go looking for Very Games here, because they don't want to give up any more weapons. And the bomb has exploded. There we go. So we are going to see a 13-10, in fact, 14-10 scoreline now, I should say.
Indeed. And now Very Games will have to transfer some money from their offshore accounts. As you can see, it's not a problem for them.
Kenny has bought his AWP, but one more loss here, and that's going to mean that Kenny's going to be pretty much flat broke. So
we have three of the Very Games player without helmet, and that's that plays a huge role. So they're starting to reach that. they don't got a lot of money left, Jay. So this is not only an important round because Navi will get that 15th point, but it's also pretty much they're scraping the bottom of their money right now.
To be honest, CT side helmets not as important as they are for T's. I mean, that's to address the balance between the AK and the M4 pricing, obviously, because the AK...
that is true.
Yeah, the AK, even with you know, a helmet on, will blow your brains out the back of your head, basically, whereas the M4, you buy body armor and a helmet, you know, it stops that first headshot, you get the dink noise, and you're good to go. And, you know, obviously, it's going to drop you down to some 13 health, but you're still alive, you're still an effective threat, so... We are seeing now, it looks like, a very slow, methodical setup here from T's and Navi. I was just about to say, it's the first time in the second half we've actually seen a push over towards B now. Are they going to use this as a fake? Oh, Starix with the Molotov. He's trying to just deny the approaches here. As you can see, he's spraying down. This is a good strat from Navi. I have to say, I'm pleasantly surprised. Kenny, though, going to pick up Starix. And a second frag onto Edward. Is he going to find the third one? Scream with the M4 headshot. Not before Zeus could take down Smith, though. As you can see, Zeus here just chilling out mid. 3-on-2 situation. Kenny with 12 HP, but he is the AWPer, so as long as he gets his first bullet off, he's probably going to get a kill here.
They are getting that flank from CT spawn. Will it? Kenny get the
air? Nice.
Kenny's been huge this round. That's his third kill, and Zeus coming in from behind now.
And you can see Zeus getting that flashbang out. Just managed to grab the kill to Scream, so it makes it 2-on-1, but that's going to be the
fourth
kill from Kenny, and with a grenade, so he finishes it off in style. Nicely done. That's now 14-11, and are Navi going to be... Yep, looks like they are going to be buying. Edward's already got an AK. Markov and Zeus also picking up weaponry, so... What's Starix doing? Is he just waiting to buy, or...? I don't think I've seen Starix buy yet. Let's see what Starix is up to.
Here we go. He's buying now.
Oh, okay. He seems to be
just a little bit of calling and talking in spawn, but... Did not see a weapon on him though. I'm just gonna check that.
We
got a drop
eventually.
In spawn. Yeah. So they're also scraping their money right now. It's not a lot of money going around for these teams right now. So losing a round will be fatal for them really.
Look at what Starix is doing. That's a little cheeky. He's going over towards B to perhaps try and get a pick here. If he does get that pick onto B, that will open up the bombsite approach, but it's a fairly long rotation on Mirage, to be honest, over towards B if you'd stacked outside of the right-hand side of A, which as at the moment Navi seem to be. So even if we do see a point where there is a pick on B, it doesn't necessarily mean that they're going to get the rotation in before the CT rotation comes.
Let's see. Starix just holding holding that subway area, really. He will be rotating through onto mid soon, I think, and maybe try to catch the rotating CTs out from the window. I think that's the game plan of Na'Vi right now, as they push onto that bomb site to get that bomb planted. He is really
balls of steel from C9. That was.
Oh, it's going to be taken out now by Xixens, and it's going to be down to a 5v4 now. Edward also down to 18 HP. It's going to be hard for Na'Vi to hold this. They haven't really been good at holding those after plants on that A bomb site, Jay.
No, it's basically boils down to the fact that they just rushed in and planted on sort of 5v5 situations now. Obviously, the second you do that, even if you've got smoke cover, Fairy Games are going to know that you're trying to retreat off site. They're going to put nades onto it as soon as they hear the plant go down. And basically, just what you saw there. And the retake, obviously, is a stunted retake. They come in sort of, you know, in twos and twos. And they get enough damage onto Na'Vi to knock them back, put them into sort of, you know, a really vulnerable position with the flashbangs.
Yeah.
They start the defuse before, you know, before everyone's been eliminated, but because they have positional advantage on the retake because of the flash and smokes that they're using, really it's not allowing Na'Vi to actually get a sniff in to try and, you know, kill the defuser. So I think at this point now, if I was calling for Na'Vi, I'd say, look, no more plants until we at least have a numerical advantage.
I think the way they're playing it out is great because all of the Na'Vi players are in great position for the afterplant, but all of a sudden he just starts for the defuse right away. They're waiting for the pushes from CT, getting those crossfire positions that they're in. But Kenny S don't care about that. He just wants that bomb defused. And that makes the Na'Vi team a bit uncertain about what to do, really. And you've seen that happen time after time here. They just can't stop that early defuse getting in.
Yeah, it basically boils down to the fact, a lot of it as well, is the fact that when they're smoking that bomb site up, it's affording the CTs the cover to move around the back of the bomb site.
Yeah.
So it's working, you know, it's working for them to get the plant, but it's working against them towards the retake. So I'm not surprised the way that it's unfolded so far in the second half, to be honest. I mean, it's two distinct halves. I mean, we saw Very Games with a completely different T-side approach where they were just going for kills and then the plant. And we're seeing Na'Vi again, that quick rush onto the site. It's almost like I'm watching a game of COD 4 here. and we're going to see the attempted retake here from Very Games, which should be successful, to be honest, because they have a positional advantage. The second that they know that bomb's gone down, they know somebody's moving from site, you know, the rest of Na'Vi are going to be behind covering, probably in very close proximity now. As we see, it looks like we're going to see a kill from Zeus, but three kills come in, two from Existence and one from Kenny. And this retake is pretty much a foregone conclusion here. And as Markov trying to hold his corners, not going to happen for him. Lots of spray coming in. MBK is going to pick up the kill into C9. Markov going to be dropped by Existence.
And would you
and the whole
it?
Time we had the defuse going on here.
Yeah,
anyway.
Would you believe it? Kenny S is sitting on the defuse, Jay.
Yep.
What a surprise.
And for a team the caliber of Na'Vi to not realize what's going on here, you would think that they would switch it up by this point.
To be honest, what I would like to see from Na'Vi, it's a little bit cheeky. But you know where you can plant by the ladder, yeah? Mm-hmm. Pretty much the first place you can plant. There's two boxes where you can hide behind. I would like to see Na'Vi just put one player there. And
yeah, whoever rushes in for the plant, yeah.
Just face rush in and just get that kill, and you will be taken out, but at least you stop Kenny S from getting on that defuse.
Yeah, and probably it would cost at least two flashbangs to get that kill, because by the time, obviously, the initial flashbang is going to go towards the bomb.
Yeah.
The second flashbang is going to go towards the box. Meaning that that's two flashbangs wasted on the retake, which means your guys coming in shouldn't be blind. Once so it's a huge difference, you know what I mean? Have we got a pause here?
No. But once again, they are going for that A bomb site, Jay. They're really having a hard... I think they are doing it because they know that they can get in and plan it without losing any players. They're just... They're insane, really.
But yeah, I mean, it's one thing to say, okay, we can get the plant here without anybody actually, you know, dropping, but it's the retake that's doing it. I mean, there's this devastating retakes from Very Games here. They seem quite happy to concede the plants and give up, you know, what is basically, I don't know, because we've had so many runs in Very Games' favor, obviously Na'Vi aren't struggling to buy, but basically early game, we saw this over and over and over again, where Very Games were conceding sort of the light buy to them, but they were quite happy to do so because they knew that the retake was going to come in. And again, Screaming Existence showing how it should be done. See Edward with the frag, Starix, in fact, Starix with the assistance from Edward. Able with an AK headshot
once again.
Yeah, I mean this is just standard fare now. I don't understand why Na'Vi haven't actually figured out either we need to push more guys onto site and cover the defuse, or we need to get a numerical advantage and actually not burn as many flashbangs coming in.
I'm speechless, Jay. I'm really disappointed seeing Na'Vi.
It literally is the definition of insanity. It's repeating the same thing over and over and expecting different results. And really, at this point now, very games have got to be sat there just like, oh, we love this game.
I think they're laughing, to be honest. Like, oh, we're doing this every round. Why are they not picking up on it? It's they need to reinvent themselves, really. And
unless
they need
this
to
is
do
some
now.
Crazy, like, fourth, you know, game point strat that Navi have where they're just going to just smash B to pieces now.
Yeah.
Which, to be honest, I don't think they are.
No, look on the overview. You see a very hesitant and defensive Navi team. I think it's a wise decision also, because Very Games are pretty known for, in these 14 rounds or the closing rounds, to actually just go for that face plant push as a CT. So they have done their homework on Very Games. I'll give them that. But once again, they are setting up for that A bomb site push, Jay. And I don't know, man. What's Edward doing?
Let's have a look. I just had spotlight on him then. 1 second. Let's go through.
He seems
to be just holding an angle here, trying to cut the rotation, but. Really, I mean, cutting the rotation is one thing, but if you can't stop the rotation coming around the backside of the bomb site to actually get the ninja defuse in, it's not gonna matter one iota, really. And even if he does pick up one kill out of that, he could be used more on site. Now, here we go, another plant, 5-on-5 situation yet again. I think it's just a case of rinse and repeat here. Navi are just hoping that it is going to be successful at least one time. As you can see, so far not, though. Zeus is going to be dropped on the platform here, so A high has been cleared out. We're going to see Scream start to move in now. He's coming in from the rotation. C9 does manage to grab himself a second AK-47 frag, but he's going to be dropped by Scream. It's now a 3-on-2, mate. Well, sorry, it was a 4-on-2.
Oh,
now a
Edward!
On two. Edward coming in, though. He's going to... Oh, but again, Ninja Diffuse.
Oh, 1 second remaining. Will he get the kill? No! Kenny S once again get... Oh, Kenny!
I want Kenny's babies at this point. They'd be like the best CS commentators ever. It's just playstyle is so ridiculous. I mean, that's got to be at least the fifth Ninja Diffuse he's hit in this half. And to follow it up with a no-scope at that sort of range at this level of play is just ridiculous.
I would love to have a talk with Kenny S after this game. And just, I imagine him smiling and just laughing and enjoying this game so much. Because it must be so fun for him just going in and defusing all the time. It's like he meets no resistance at all.
Yeah. basically what's happening is that they're pushing. It's usually C9 who just charges in because he's obviously the most aggressive player from Navi. But what's happening is, and we've seen this now, I think that's like the seventh round in a row where we've seen a plant retake.
Yeah.
Very Games are quite happy to concede the plant, obviously, because they know that it basically leaves C9 vulnerable when he's moving away from the plant. So. At this point now, it's basically game point here, and I'd have to say that from what we've seen, be very surprised if Navi pick up this last round of the first map here. I think it's going to go 1-0 over to Very Games.
Jay, I'm going to go out on a limb here. Seeing as this is the last round, they're doing the exact same. Navi's going to pick up this round. For some obscure reason, it's going to work this last round.
Maybe pressure's going to get to Very Games. It looks like Starix is going to get the opening headshot, so... First time they have had a rush plant with a numerical advantage, so it does bode well here, I suppose. They've actually managed to get grenades out onto the rotation as well, so they're going to slow the rotation down. MBK making his way back to the A ramp, though. He's going to be coming from behind, and he does have the perfect position here to get the flank, and he's got a grenade to go out as well. And it's going to give his position away, but at least it establishes, you know, that he knows that there's nobody in that spot. Now MBK with the headshot, the second headshot, and the third one!
MBK.
Beast mode engaged, two members of Navi left. It's going to be Starix and Marco off. You can see Starix on the elevated position above the site. Going to grab one frag onto MBK, so that's the hat-trick hero shut down. Now the diffuser has also been shut down, and again shut down. That bomb's going to explode, and that's going to be a tied game. So we are going to go into, are we going to go into overtime here on the first map?
I think we are, to be honest, yeah. Because no one's coming from...